Welcome to another webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, the fog crawler.
Hi, I'm Joni, the teardrop nanny. We're here in Six Rivers National Forest in Northern California at a wonderful little campground called Boise Creek. It goes down to the Willow Creek, and then which that leads into the Trinity River. Today, I'll be keeping along with a new location, new recipe, dusting off one from the family favorites, Kielbasa Skillet Stew.
Stay tuned.
Here's what's in today's pantry box for Kielbasa Skillet Stew. Of course, we have a Polska Kielbasa. This one's turkey. This one is a combination Polska Kielbasa with pork, turkey, and beef. You need about 1.5 pounds. I also have butter, bell pepper. You can use green or red. Onion, 2 cans of Great Northern. Those are the white beans. Tomato sauce, diced green chilies, some carrots, and for seasoning, I have thyme, black pepper, and Italian seasoning. To see the full recipe, click on Show More after you scroll down, and you can see the full recipe to print out. I'm going to start with this skillet. I have 3 tablespoons of softened butter that I will be letting melt. If you are using a camp oven or a Dutch oven, you need to start over with medium heat, probably about 2 dozen coals. Today we're using the gas and propane. Now that this butter has melted over some medium heat, I'm going to add in 1 medium onion that I chopped up, 2 medium-sized carrots will go in next. I'm a fond user of baby carrots. I like those because they're of uniform size. They're already washed, and they're already peeled. I'm going to cook these carrots and onions over medium heat until the onions have become softened. The onions have softened up, and I'll add in 1/2 of a medium chopped bell pepper. My mom always liked to use green bell pepper, and that was because when we were kids, that's pretty much all you could find at the store, green bell pepper. Red bell pepper and colored bell peppers always were more expensive, and they weren't always readily available. Once I have that stirred in, I'll go ahead and add in the sausage. The sausage has been sliced up. This was always a favorite of the family. When everybody had been working late in the garden, or if the guys had gone out for a late afternoon hunt, because it was one that you could keep simmering on the stove. I'll put these in and they'll cook about 6 to 7 minutes. This sausage is already pre-cooked. It's a smoked sausage. Sometimes my dad would see if he could get linguica instead, but my favorite was the sausage. Once this has been cooking about 6 to 7 minutes, that bell pepper should tenderize up, and then I'll be ready to increase the heat to this skillet and add in the rest of the remaining ingredients. That sausage and bell pepper have cooked up. I'm going to add in the beans now. I have 2 cans of Great Northern beans, 15 ounces each, and I want to add them in undrained. That's going to bring my heat down a little bit. I'm going to add in a can of tomato sauce. This is a 15-ounce can. And lastly, 4 ounces of the chopped green chilies. These are the mild ones. For the seasonings, I have 1/2 teaspoon of Italian seasoning and 1/2 teaspoon of dried thyme, and 1/8 teaspoon of pepper, and I also put a little tiny dash of some kosher salt in there. As you can see, the heat is still on here. Once I stir this all up, I'll bring it to a boil. Then I'll reduce the heat, cover it, and I'll let it simmer for 20 to 25 minutes. I'm going to give it an occasional stir here. Coloring up nicely. And time to activate your smell-o-vision. We'll be eating probably in less than 5 minutes. Get your bowl ready. There you have it. Kielbasa skillet stew. Time to put this in a bowl and eat.
We hope you enjoyed today's webisode.
Always fun to cook in the outdoors in a new location. Want to give a shout out to the camp host from Minnesota, Katrina.
Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
And until the next time, happy trails to you.